Dempsey lands a potent right-hand counter, follows up with a series of seven devastating punches. Tunney goes down for the first time in his career. Dempsey stays near the fallen fighter, but referee Dave...
Hey, Sifu Jason here with Greenville Academy Martial Arts again, and I wanted to go over a couple of boxing don'ts. Okay, boxing's changed in the last 60, 70 years. It's become much more glove-centric, especially for defense. You've seen a lot of this using the glove for defense. If you're utilizing boxing for self-defense, for street fighting, or you're using it even like, say, for MMA with the glove smaller, this can be rather problematic. It's very helpful for boxing. The glove is made, there's a lot of padding back here, why I'm wearing one glove and I'm not. That if you're using the glove for defense and you get in the habit of that, and you're using a bare knuckle back here, first of all, the back of your hand is not made to take shots. So if you're taking punches in the back of your hand, it very well might break your hand. Furthermore, your knuckles are going to drive into your head, which is going to cause swelling. It's going to cause some pain. It may even cut you. So that's not helpful. So you'll notice, if you look into boxing history, that old school boxers that especially had very small gloves on, or they had no gloves, the bare knuckle era guys, did not block like this. They didn't have their hands back. They had their hands in front of them, and they pick stuff off. They parry, especially watch Jack Johnson, they parry and they cut the corner on stuff. Whereas today, again, boxers are more like this and they're using the glove for defense, and it's still the padding here and the padding here protects my hand and my face. But without it, that's problematic. Also, the boxers in the old school days would stay back a little bit. And the reason they stay back, and you're seeing it starting in MMA today, Ronda Rousey's boyfriend did this in his last fight, where there's a lot of accidental eye jabs. So if your face is forward and the guy's got his fingers free, you could get poked in the eye. And an eye poke is not a good thing. Look at the first Ali Frazier fight. Ali landed hundreds of shots on Frazier that Frazier walked through, because Frazier was tough. And the worst damage Frazier took in that fight was from the middle-aged referee, Arthur McCanty. He went to break him, and he slipped. His hand slipped, and he thumbed Frazier in the eye. And that Frazier had to take a second to get himself together. So an accidental eye jab, even from an enemy that just isn't aware of what he's doing, he's just absent-mindedly pokes you in the eye as you're coming forward, could end the fight for you. So boxing doesn't have a problem because you can't get the thumb free, you just can't poke anybody in the eye. So the game has changed, become more face forward and more glove for defense. When in reality, if you're not fighting that way, you're not fighting in this ring with the ring rules, then you've got to make sure you understand that, or it could be used against you and be very dangerous. So you end up having this problem of actually executing your discipline and losing because of it. So you always want to know why you're doing what you're doing and when what you're doing won't work. You know, there's a lot of tactics that will work in here or in a cage that you don't necessarily want to bring to a street fight. And several years ago, I was at an MMA fight and the guys hit the cage. And one guy just slammed the other guy against the cage, and the last man out of the cage didn't bolt the door shut. So he hit the door and they flew out, and I was like 6 feet down and hit the cement. And their next stop was the emergency room, you know? So, that was as real as it gets. So always remember where you're fighting and what the environment is. And I don't mean to knock boxing or MMA, but it's not street fighting. And so you always want to make sure that your tactics are up to date and you don't just start doing something absent-mindedly. Okay? Hope this helped.